OOKU versus Dugato round watercolor brushes. Which is better? Keep watching to find out. Hey everybody, welcome to my studio. In this video, I'm going to compare two sets of watercolor brushes that I use all the time in my studio, the OOKU brand and the Dugato brand. As you can see, the OOKU set comes with six brushes, two flat and six round brushes, whereas the Dugato set comes with four rounds only. So for the sake of comparison, I'm going to not really talk about these two flat wool brushes and just focus instead on the four round brushes in each set. As you can see, the OOKU brushes come in four sizes, 6, 4, 2, and 1. And the Dugato brushes come in sizes 6, 4, 2, and 0. We'll talk a bit more about that in a minute. Let's start with looking at the OOKU brand. Again, 6, 4, 2, and 1 are the sizes. And I'm going to go ahead and talk about the pros and cons of each of these sets. And while I do that, I think I'll just use the brushes a bit. So you can see how they perform. Let's take a look at the six first. If you compare the six to the Dugato six, you'll see that the size of the OOKU brushes is quite a bit larger, even though they're both have the same number. The handles on all the OOKU brushes are substantially larger, and I like that. So I'm going to give a plus to the OOKUs for having just a better size, more substantially sized handle, wooden handle. They both have wooden handles and they're both nicely made and all, but the OOKUs are a bit more substantial in size, and I like that. The bristles, the head on the brushes of the six, if I get these Dugato brushes wet also and then compare these side by side wet, you're going to see it's not super noticeable, but the OOKU brushes have a bigger belly, a bigger radius here at the heel of the brush where the bristles meet the ferrule. And I believe that the six OOKU can hold more water and paint than the number six Dugato. And so even though they have the same number, they are not the same size by any means. So I'm going to give a plus to the OOKU for the size of its number six as well. Now I've just mixed up a big puddle of ultramarine blue, and I've got my my number six OOKU here, and you can see I'm just bringing it over my paper here. I can go from a really fine point with this number six and then also a really, really substantial wash because of the size of the brush, and again holding a lot of paint, I can really do a wash that would cover almost an entire piece of 12 by 9 paper quite easily. And most squirrel hair brushes, not only do they hold a lot of water, but they come to a fine point. They just are a really a versatile brush because of the fine point combined with the big belly. One negative aspect of the OOKU set is the relative size of their two smallest brushes. Here I have the two and the one brush for the OOKU set. And you can see that the bristles and heads here are almost the exact same size, even though they are a number two and a number one. This, when compared to the two smallest brushes of the Dugato set, the two and the zero, their two brushes have a real noticeable size difference. And I kind of like that in the Dugato set. Here's the number four OOKU brush. Again, a really thirsty brush with a big belly, holds a lot of water, comes to a fine point, as well as really giving you a nice, beautiful dispersion of the pigment. That's the number four. Here is the number two. Again, being even a little smaller in size, we can get to a real fine point there, holding lots of water. And here is the number one in the OOKU set. And really, I could paint an entire painting with just these four brushes. This number six is so large, can really handle some big wash areas, and these other brushes come to a real fine point. And I think that they're a great brush. Again, they are a squirrel hair blend. They have squirrel hair, but they blend with nylon, so they are a hybrid brush. This is compared to the Dugato brush, which is a 100% squirrel hair brush. I have to say I like the 100% Dugato squirrel hair brush a little bit more, I think, in terms of the way it performs, but really can't complain with this OOKU set either. They're both perform real well, and I love the heads on these brushes. Now let's take a look at the Dugato brushes. Again, as I've already mentioned, the number six is quite a bit smaller than the six in the OOKU, so I wish it was a little bit bigger. But there's a nice size difference here between the two smaller brushes. They do number them 2 and 0, so that makes a bit more sense. This Dugato 0 is quite a bit smaller than anything in the OOKU set. Okay, so as with the OOKU set, these Dugato brushes come to a very nice tip when you get them wet, and they hold lots of water and paint. And this is, again, the number 6. So while it's smaller than the OOKU brand brush at the number 6 size, it still does a great job of carrying a lot of water and paint. Here is the number 4 in the Dugato set. Again, really similar. I really think that all of these brushes perform very similarly. Here is the number 2 Dugato. And again, here's that final, smallest one, the Dugato 0. And again, one of the reasons I like the Dugato set is it has this smaller brush in it. And this could almost be used as a rigger, because you can see how fine the lines could get with this number 0. Another advantage of the Dugato set is it's slightly less expensive. As of my taping of this video today, the Dugato set of 4 comes about $39. The OOKU set, which you can purchase just the 4 round brushes, that set comes in at $30 or $40. So it's a difference of about $1 or $2 on Amazon as of this video taping. So they're very similar in price, but the Dugato comes in at just slightly less expensive. Here's the number 4 brush in both sets. As I mentioned earlier, you can see again the OOKU handles are more substantial and a little bit thicker. Also, one other difference I didn't mention is the metal that's used here at the ferrule to crimp the ferrule onto the brush handle. This is very important in terms of the construction of the brush. The Dugato brushes have what looks like copper wire, and the OOKU brushes use what looks like aluminum, but they say it's stainless steel. Actually, their description on Amazon is somewhat inconsistent. In one place they say they use stainless steel, and another place they say they use aluminum. So I'm not really sure which it is. The Dugato brushes don't even say on their Amazon page what kind of metal it is at all. They just say it's a metal wire. So it looks like copper to me. So really though, the most important thing is you want to buy something that doesn't rust. And so again, if these are stainless or these are copper, in either case, they're not going to rust. And I haven't had any problems with rust with either of these sets since I purchased them. I've been using them consistently, almost daily, for the last several months, and haven't had any rust problems with either one. And so I can't complain about that in either case. Another thing is just whether or not the brushes shed is another consideration. And I have not had any problems with these brushes shedding their bristles after the first one or two times using them. Almost all brushes, when you first use them the first time or two, will shed some bristles, and so don't be worried about that. If they continue to shed bristles consistently after you've used them and broken them in, then that's a bit more of a concern. I have not found either of these sets of brushes to really have a problem with that at all. The OOKU brushes come packaged in this wool pouch, which is nice. It looks nice and all. However, before I had had them for even more than a month or so, the handle on the zipper broke off here. It's almost impossible to open. I found this pouch to be somewhat useless because of that. The Dugato brushes, on the other hand, came in a nice box, which is really nice for presentation if you're giving it as a gift. And I like that. However, I don't store the brushes in this box, so I didn't find it to be super useful after I initially opened them. So they both attempted to do a nice packaging. The Dugato brush is better for gift giving because it's really a nice box. The OOKU pouch is really not very good quality in my opinion. And so I would have to say the Dugato brush comes out a little bit ahead in that regard, but I don't really use either of these packages now that I am using the brushes in my studio. So how do these two sets of brushes come out in the head-to-head comparison? I would have to say that in terms of the handles, I like the OOKUs better. In terms of the bristles and the size of the brush heads, I think they're somewhat equal. I like the number 6 size better here, but I like the number 0 size better here, so it's somewhat of a wash. In terms of the type of bristles, I have to say I like the Dugato better because I like the 100% squirrel hair over the blend, but really, again, the blend is a nice type of bristle as well, and you may have a preference either way. If you like the blend, then you would want to go with the OOKU. If you like 100% natural, go with the Dugato. In terms of the ferrule and the type of metal used, I think I kind of like the copper better, maybe just because I like the way it looks. But really, in terms of its quality of construction and that kind of thing, they're really pretty much equal. Neither of them are rusting or having any problems holding together, so I think they're both great. In terms of the price, the Dugato comes out slightly ahead, but just barely, maybe a dollar or two less expensive. And when it comes down to packaging, again, I think they're somewhat equal. The nice box of the Dugato set is a nice feature if you're giving it as a gift. So that's it, folks. That's my head-to-head comparison of OOKU versus Dugato. I like both sets of brushes, and I think they both work great. I use them side by side all the time in my studio, and I can highly recommend either set. I hope this video has been helpful. If so, please give it a like and maybe subscribe to my channel, and I put out videos like this about once a week. Thanks for watching. See you next time.